Hey, welcome to the round table. Today I am joined by the godfather of air guns, Mr. Tom Gaylord, our hunter Jim Chapman, and our gun critic Rick Eutsler. Gentlemen, today we're talking about one of my favorite topics in the air gun world.
We knew you love it. We
just I saw it on the list today and I got super excited.
Yeah.
Foot pounds.
Yes.
What in the world does it mean?
What does it mean and why do I care? This is what I need to understand.
We don't think you do care.
Because let me tell you something. I speak for the average, maybe less intelligent air gunner out there that's still learning, still trying to figure out the guns that they like in general. And when you start talking foot pounds, not going to lie, you confuse me.
I wouldn't say less intelligent.
I would
less
say that's
experience.
An oxymoron.
Yeah.
They gun for air guns, so they're more intelligent, right?
Right. The more you know, the less you care, right? What is foot pounds? Godfather, to you.
It's energy.
Okay. And
I'm going to give you an example of energy.
This foot is pounds of what?
Foot pounds.
Give me the
it
what's
the
whole thing.
It is energy that is needed to move 1 pound 1 foot of distance. There's a lot of suppositions in what I just said, and I'm not going to go into them in this right now.
Thank God.
But it is the energy necessary to move 1 pound 1 foot. And it's how we measure horsepower. The power of anything like an engine is measured in horsepower, but horsepower is a number of foot pounds that a particular device can generate. Okay? Let me give you an example, though.
Okay.
I'll make it simple. In the Civil War,
I'm going to make it simple.
No, come on. This is easy.
All right.
Obviously, South, North, they fought with lines. So you had lines of the bad guys and lines of us, okay? And they used, well, we're never the bad guys. And they had
cannon. I can't tell you where he's from. Just use your imagination.
And they had cannon.
Yeah.
And the cannon were firing 6 pound and 12 pound cannonballs.
Okay.
And they weren't going very fast, about 300, 350 feet per second. So as soon as they get out of the cannon, they start bouncing along the ground and they're, of course, skipping towards the bad guys, mm-hmm. right? And you're on the side that the ball's coming towards, and it doesn't look like it's moving very fast. So hundreds of soldiers, when the ball was coming at them, would stick out their hand to touch as it went by, and it would take off their arm at the shoulder, or they would take off their leg at the joint, and they would die.
Sure.
That's energy. That's tens of thousands of foot-pounds of energy. Instead of being hit by the Toyota at 5 miles an hour and being bumped in your car, you were hit by a 1-mile-long freight train at 5 miles an hour, and you were pushed for a mile down the tracks.
Mm-hmm.
It's the difference in energy.
So it has nothing to do with feet per second? Or
well, it does.
It does.
It's a function of the velocity and the weight of the projectile. I'll give you another example. To me, a practical one from a hunting standpoint. Everybody is used to looking at velocity. You know, that's what we see in the firearm world. It's what you see on the boxes when you're buying a gun. This gun does 1,000 feet per second.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't tell me as a hunter what it's going to do on game. If I shoot a 1,000 feet per second with something as light as a speck of dust, isn't going to cause any injury, any impact. It's not transferring any energy. 1,000 feet per second with a 20-grain pellet is going to cause a lot of damage. You have transfer a lot of energy. So when you talk about velocity, part of the reason air gun manufacturers do that is that so firearms people that are used to thinking in terms of velocity have some understanding what the gun can do. My 22 rimfire does 1,200 feet per second, so an air gun doing 1,200 feet per second should be about the same.
Mm-hmm.
It's not, because a 22 is using a much heavier projectile, but it's still, it gives them something
and
to benchmark.
And it's moving at a faster rate.
Right. Even if it's at the same velocity.
They can be the same velocity,
okay, same velocity,
but
different weights.
Weights, right.
Rimfire bullet
so
is 40 grains, and your air gun pellet is 7 grains.
Which essentially gives it more
power.
Foot pounds or knockdown power.
There you go.
Okay, so that's what you want to know. And so we're in this situation now where air gun manufacturers have to use velocity because it's what a couple companies started with now. Everybody's in this kind of arms race about the velocity. But what I want to know as a hunter is what it's going to do on game, on target. So going to the energy level tells me that. Now, the other thing is that it's still useful to have the velocity information because it gives me a benchmark. How do the guns compare against each other? But I may take a gun that's advertised as doing 1,000 feet per second that used a very light pellet, which I don't think is going to be effective for hunting.
Mm-hmm.
And I may go to a heavier pellet twice as heavy. and it slows it down to 800 feet per second, but it delivers more energy to the target, especially at a longer range, because here's the other thing. Lighter pellets lose energy more quickly. So if I have a light pellet that I'm shooting at the muzzle that's 1,000, and I have a lead pellet that's 800 feet per second, at 50 yards, the lead pellet will actually retain a higher velocity than the hyperlight alloy.
Yeah. Yeah.
So what I'm actually delivering is more energy further down. So that's why we kind of always get into this discussion about velocity and energy.
Mm-hmm. Here's something to consider, too. We've got a couple guns here that if you looked at them just on paper, this is a 650 foot per second gun. This is a 650 foot per second gun.
Mm-hmm.
The difference is this is 650 in 22 caliber. This is 650 in 177.
Okay.
This is going to have a lot more energy than this. So if little Johnny is going to try and shoot squirrels or something in the backyard, and he sees 650 feet per second, and he grabs this gun, he's going to be far less effective and maybe not effective at all. Where this gun, he may be highly effective.
Right.
The difference is the foot-pounds of energy that's going to get delivered.
And as another another example in the United Kingdom, where you could argue that's the motherland, fatherland, however you want to term it, of air gunning. That's where a lot of the serious adult air gunning came from. They have a law in place that no air gun over 12 foot-pound of energy can be used without a firearms license. If it's more than 12 foot-pound, mm-hmm. it's considered a firearm. So the vast majority, and they have a huge number of hunters in the U.K., I mean, a huge
thousands,
number.
Tens of thousands.
They have three magazines dedicated to air gun hunting alone, and so they have a restriction of 12 foot pound. Most of our guns, at minimum, are 12 foot pound.
Yeah. Right.
But that the government wanted to regulate what they felt was important about the power of a gun. They didn't look at velocity. They don't say at all what the velocity limitation is. It's all what the power is, because that's what really has meaning in terms of what the gun can do downrange.
And we have some different, we go from maybe like a 12-foot-pound to a 9-foot-pound. You said the new Rotec from
20.
About 20. And this one was upwards of over 200-foot-pound.
This is the 50 cal.
This
same
is the exactly.
200-foot-pound.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So again, so a lot of knockdown power. So that's why obviously I'm sure it skips quite a bit when you get into the big bore guns,
does.
Right? Because we're talking about very heavy pellets
or bullets.
Bullets.
And yet the velocity of that gun is not much higher than the velocity of this gun.
It's actually more like this one.
It's probably about 650. It's really slow, but you're pushing a 230 or larger grain bullet.
So other than hunting, because it makes sense for hunting, because again, you want to deliver as much energy as you can, because you want to kill everything you're going after humanely.
Yes.
You want to hit it, you want it to fall. When else does it play, and does it matter?
Okay, so a time where I really think velocity is important, when I'm just trying to figure out what a gun will do trajectory-wise.
Right.
Because the thing is that the lower the velocity, the longer the projectile is hanging out there, the longer gravity has to work with it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's gonna fall more. So a gun that's shooting at 1,000 feet per second and a gun that's shooting at 600 feet per second, at 50 yards, the one at 1,000, if it's a heavy enough pellet, is gonna have a trajectory like this. The one that's at the lower velocity is gonna have a trajectory that goes like this.
Drops down.
Okay, so this is all good information, but can you draw it up in a diagram so that I can look at it and go, got it, 177 is 22, and like pellets and grains, and so it makes sense, so we can help these people understand what foot-pounds, why
I'd say right here. Right here, there'll be a chair gun chart that shows you the difference. But there's a tool that lets you look at the projectile weight and the velocity, and it plots out a graph that shows you what happens with it. It is a function of distance.
Okay.
Range.
So I'm understanding, most importantly, though, this comes into, typically into hunting.
No, there is one other thing, and that is target shooting. It's just the reverse. In target shooting, you don't need a lot of energy. And they make backstops for target air guns very thin because they don't have to stop a lot of energy.
Okay, so field target, stuff
not field target.
10 meter, I'm talking about bullseye targets for the Olympics.
Mm-hmm.
They only expect about 6 foot-pounds or less. If you hit that backstop with a 12-foot-pound gun, which we think is not too powerful, it's going to go through the backstop.
Right.
So in target shooting, and I admit that's a niche, but you've got over 1 million young people in this country doing it every year, In target shooting, it's just the reverse. You want as low foot-pounds as possible while still maintaining accuracy.
Rossi, remember when those ladies wearing the leather jackets just thrashed you at target shooting?
Yes, I did.
That was where you want to, where you want a lower velocity gun, right?
That's right.
Okay, so there you go. Apparently, foot-pounds is way more important than I want it to be.
There you go.
It is.
It's just not that easy to understand.
It isn't. And when you start out, like when I did, I bought everything based on that feet per second.
That's what's on, it's on the bottom, and that's what all you see before you even see the name of the gun.
It took me, Tom and I talking and me reading his blog, and it took me time to sort of get past that and understand more thoroughly that those numbers, they're marketing a lot of times. Mm-hmm. But really what's really important is the energy that you're going to impart in your game. Because a lot of people, and I think a lot of people buy air guns to kill something.
Sure.
They're pest elimination, they're going to hunt. I mean, back in their mind, they're thinking, I'm going to hunt with this or I'm going to shoot a pest with it. Mm-hmm. And so that's where, you know, that number becomes somewhat of an issue. If they're buying it based on that, understanding how foot-pounds plays in and how the weight of the pellet plays in, being able to calculate that and know your gun more thoroughly, I think that's just really important.
Is there a basic rule of thumb when it comes to the understanding or just foot pounds in general when you're looking for a gun for whatever the reason?
Well, I'll give you the magic number. I think that's a kind of a basic rule.
Ooh, there's a magic number.
There is a magic number. 671.
671.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
That's the magic number.
It's the area. No, it's. It's the number at which the velocity in, the weight of the pellet in grains, 7 grains, equals the foot-pounds. 671 feet per second, a 7-grain pellet generates 7 foot-pounds, a 25-grain pellet generates 25 foot-pounds. So if I'm buying a 1,000-foot-per-second gun, and it only shoots 7-grain pellets, I'm not going to generate the same energy as if I'm buying an 800-foot-per-second gun that shoots 30-grain pellets.
Okay.
Magic number,
at least you can go, like, if I'm getting at least 671, I know at least whatever grain pellet I'm shooting, that's how much foot-pound I'm
getting. Yeah.
Okay.
And an easier way also, if you want to buy a small game hunting gun, 12 to 20 foot-pound, you're golden.
If you're
buying a Springer especially, 12 to 20 foot-pound, you'll take any game that you should be able to take. So
regardless of the caliber.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. There you go. That was easy. I know this is a lot of information. If you guys want more, or hopefully we can actually find a chart and put it up on AmericanAirGunner.com, check. See if it's there. That's it for this. If you're as confused as I am, you know what? Just keep Googling it. But these guys all have videos and articles and things they've talked about that can help you understand if you want to go get a gun, whatever you need it for, what foot-pounds you need. And I think that's good when you're talking about 12 to 20, if you're talking about knocking things down. And as far as target practice, it really doesn't matter unless you're just not accurate. Okay, so figure it out. I hope we helped. I don't know. That's it. We're done. Stay with us. There's more American Airgunner coming up right after this.